فاسألوا أهل الذكر إن كنتم لا تعلمون.
إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كلام الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. Brothers and sisters in Islam, when the angel Jibril alayhi salam wanted to assure Hajar that she's going to be okay, her and her son Ismail alayhi salam, after Nabiullah Ibrahim dropped them in Mecca, he said to her, "Don't worry. Inna lillahi baytan hahuna. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has a house right here. يبنيه هذا الولد وأبوه." The foundation of this house will be raised by this infant and his father. As if Jibreel alayhi salam is telling her, this is the house of Allah. Whenever you reside, live next to the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will take care of you. Brothers and sisters in Islam, when Ibrahim alayhi salam returned back to Palestine, very interesting, al-Isra'iliyat, and we mean by the Israelites here, آثار أهل الكتاب والتي لا نصدقها ولا نكذبها. The news from the books of the people of the book completely abandoned the story. Totally. Completely. No word. Imagine a father takes his wife, his son, places them in the desert, and that's it. Again, the final revelation The Quran and the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam came to say no to that. In fact, we have authentic accounts of four visits Ibrahim alayhi salam made from Jerusalem, Al-Quds of Palestine, to Mecca. One of them in the Quran, Qissat al-Dhabih, the story of the sacrifice, Dhabh, and three in Hadith ibn Abbas, which is in Al-Bukhari or Muslim. It's very interesting. Again, it's just the promotion, as if Ismail and his mother was a mistake in the life of Ibrahim, and that mistake has to be removed. Promoting that idea of special people and people who are lower in class. Subhanallah. When they came to the story of al-dhabih, the story of the sacrifice, they ended up saying that the boy who was to be sacrificed was Ishaq, not Ismail. For us as Muslims, it doesn't matter. And dare you make this an issue. لا نفرق بين أحد من رسلي. We love Ishaq as much as we love Ismail and the rest of the messengers and prophets. But you see, they were driven to say it's Ishaq because Ismail is already what? We don't want to mention him again. We don't want to mention him again. But they did something very interesting. If you read their literature, which I do not encourage you, the command was, take your only son. Actually, it's still like exactly like this. Take your only son to sacrifice. Slaughter your only son. For you to learn and to know that the only child who can have that scripture, that description, I'm sorry, is Ismail. Because in no way Ishaq is the only son. Ishaq is the second son, alayhi salam. For they left that only there just as a trace. But again, for us, subhanallah, it doesn't make any difference. But this is the first journey that we know Ibrahim alayhi salam went back to Palestine. And the context of the journey in Surah As-Saffat. Ibrahim alayhi salam says, Rabbi habli min as-salihin. O Allah, bestow upon me righteous offspring. Fabashsharnahu bighulamin halim. We given him the glad tiding of a son who is forbearant. When Ibrahim alayhi salam and Sarah were given the glad tiding of Ishaq, the description was different. Inna nubashshiruka bighulamin alim. Fi Surah Al-Hijr, the angels who came to destroy the two towns of the homosexuals, Sodom and Gomorrah, in their way, they stopped by Ibrahim alayhi salam and they given him the glad tiding of Ishaq. When they given him the glad tiding of Ishaq, they said, Inna nubashiruka bighulamin alim. We're giving you the glad tiding of a son who is knowledgeable, has knowledge. So Ibrahim alayhi salam arrives Mecca, and subhanallah, him and Ismail are walking next to one another. Look at this scene. فَلَمَّا بَلَغَ مَعَهُ السَّعِي. You know, you really become so attached to your children when they start walking and speaking. As fathers. Normally the first 2 years is the mother shares. You know, even parents, fathers, they do not even pay attention to the child. Because it's changing diapers and all that stuff is, you just... But when they start speaking and communicating with you, that's when... Shuf, look at it. فَلَمَّا بَلَغَ مَعَهُ السَّعِي. When Ismail alayhi salam reached the age of walking, قيل, it was mentioned that he was around 13 years old. Shuf, look at the caliber of Ismail and look at the caliber of Ibrahim. He is sharing with his child the situation. It's a very tough situation on me. قَالَ يَا بُنَيِّ. He said, my son, إِنِّي أَرَى فِي الْمَنَامِ أَنِّي أَذْبَحُكَ. I saw a vision, a dream, commanding me to slaughter you. We know that dreams for messengers, prophets, are a form of revelations. Imagine sharing that with your son, who is 13 years old. فَانْظُرْ مَاذَا تَرَى. What do you think about that? Look what he said, I'm commanded. It's a command from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I have no choice. Command. Shuf, look at the son. قَالَ يَا أَبَتِ افْعَلْ مَا تُؤْمَرْ. My father, do what you commanded to do. Guess who said it earlier to him? Who said it earlier? The mother. Who, like mother, like son, like father, like son. يقول لك هذا الشبل من هذا الأسد. His mother, 13 years ago, he tells her, listen, I'm commanded to leave you here. She tells him, go. The son likewise. قال يا أبت افعل ما تؤمر. Do what you're commanded to do. By Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. شاف الفقه. Look at the understanding of the young boy, Ismail alayhi salam. ستجدني. You will find me. واستثنى. إن شاء الله. I'll do my best. ستجدني إن شاء الله من الصابرين. I'll be patient. إن شاء الله. ورد في الآثار that when Ibrahim عليه السلام فلما أسلما. When both of them submitted to Allah, وَتَلَّهُ لِلْجَبِينَ, he placed him in his forehead. At first, he placed him on his back. Ismail tells his father, my father, if you look at my face while you're slaughtering me, you may turn away from executing the command. Place me on my forehead so you don't have to look at my face. Submission, ya ikhwa. Submission. هذا هو الإسلام. هذا هو معنى التسليم. Compliance. Total submission to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. To the commands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Regardless what the consequences are in your own calculation. You see, sometimes our nafs, our shaitan, scares us from submitting, from doing the right things. Ya akhi, trust al-hakim, al-alim, al-khabir. Trust Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the all-wise, the all-knower. He has a wisdom. فَلَمَّا أَسْلَمَا وَتَلَّهُ لِلْجَبِينَ شوف, it was a test. وَنَادَيْنَاهُ أَيَّا إِبْرَاهِيمُ We called upon him. That's it. كَانَ هَذَا عَلَى قَبِيلِ الْإِبْتِلَاءِ This is a test from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to you. Brothers and sisters in Islam, look at the reward. يقول لك من رحم البلاء يأتي التمكين. From the womb of the tests, the empowerment comes. ومن المحنة تأتي المنحة. Out of all hardships that you go through, if you're patient, a grant will be given to you. When you go through hardships and you're patient, obedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will compensate you. شوف وَبَشَّرْنَاهُ بِإِسْحَاقِ Not only to keep your only son, وَبَشَّرْنَاهُ بِإِسْحَاقِ Just to show you that, look at the context of the verses, to tell you that it was never been Ishaq. After Ibrahim alayhi salam did this, then Allah says, وَبَشَّرْنَاهُ بِإِسْحَاقِ And as a reward for him being willing to give up his only son, we'll give him another son. From his other wife. وَبَشَّرْنَاهُ بِإِسْحَاقِ وَمِنْ وَرَاءِ إِسْحَاقَ يَعْقُوبِ And from Ishaq will come Ya'qub. This is the first trip. The second trip in the Sunnah, Ibrahim alayhi salam arrived most probably after Hajar has passed away. Ibrahim married from the tribe of Jurhum, an Arab tribe who lived around the Kaaba. Afwan, Ismail married from the tribe of Jurhum. Ismail used to work as a hunter, hunts. So he would go into the desert, disappear for a week or so, bring his hunt back to feed the family. فإبراهيم عليه السلام went to visit him. The wife did not know who is Ibrahim. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وعليكم السلام. Where is your husband? قالت, she said, خرج يقتاد لنا. يقتات لنا. He went out to bring provision for us. Then he asked her this question, كيف عيشكما? How's it going? How's your livelihood? How's life? Look what she said. بشر. Awful. It's terrible. No good. No food. No water. You can imagine what she said. This is an issue. You know, in simple words, I can convey that message to you. You have a cup, has some water in it, and empty. It's not fair to just look at the empty side of the empty portion of the cup. At least mention you're healthy, you're alive. Right away, Ibrahim alayhi salam, just to show you also that he cares about his son. Right away, he said to her, when your husband returns, أبلغيه مني السلام, convey my salam to him, my greeting to him, and to tell him that I am telling him to change his doorstep. غير عتبة دارك. Show also that the wife is the front of the... Change that. When Ismail alayhi salam returned, a husband should censor already. Somebody, I can tell there was somebody in my house. Somebody was here? Sure. You should ask when you go back home. Huh? And if when you see things in your house that you did not provide, don't just say, oh, that, Ya Maryam, anna laki hadha. You're the provider, antal kafil. Make sure that your family are not fed from unlawful. Make sure that this food is coming from a rightful source. Someone was here. Yeah, an old sheikh. And he, by the way, conveyed his salam to you. And he's commanding you to change your doorstep. He said, this is my father, and he's commanding me to divorce you. Go home. Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salam is not a wife of this caliber, by the way. Normally, you're not going to have a good time. You know, being ungrateful is one of the issues. Once it comes to women in general, yeah, we're talking about women in general, not believing Muslim women. يعني في حديث ابن عباس in the day of Eid, الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم addressed the women. He given them actually a certain a special sermon. Like after he delivered the khutbah to Eid, he went and he addressed the women. And one of the things that he said, يا معاشر النساء تصدقنا. Oh women, give a lot of sadaqah, فإني رأيتكن أكثر أهل النار. I saw you the majority of the dwellers of hell. One woman, one of the women, ran after the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. وسألت, smart, فقيها. حديث ابن عباس في البخاري, I'm not making that stuff up. Why? What's wrong? Why? قال, he said, تكفرنا العشير. You are ungrateful to the husbands. وتكفرنا الإحسان. لو أحسن إليكن الرجل الدهر كله ثم رأيتن شيئا تكرهن لقلتن ما رأينا منك خيرا قط. شوف قط هذه اللي تموت. If being ungrateful to your husbands. Now, I tell the sisters, my believing sisters, listen, your husband can be your way to Jannah and also can be your way to the other end. Right here. Look at the other end. Hadith Abdurrahman ibn Auf, في السنن, Abi Dawood, إِذَا صَلَّتِ الْمَرْأَةُ خَمْسَهَا. If the woman prays her five daily prayers, وَصَامَتْ شَهْرَهَا, and she fasts the month of Ramadan, وَحَصَّنَتْ فَرْجَهَا, and she keeps herself chaste, وَحَصَّنَتْ فَرْجَهَا, وَأَطَاعَتْ زَوْجَهَا, and she obeyed her husband in what is reasonable. Look, sisters, in the day of resurrection, you stand in front of the eight gates of Jannah. Eight gates of Jannah. She gets to choose which gate she wants to go to Jannah from. You choose which gate. فالموضوع هكذا, موضوع جنة ونار أصلا, مش موضوع women وanti women ولا الكلام ده خالص, موضوع جنة ونار. If your agenda is جنة, this is the way. If your agenda بقى promotion, some western terminology, women are bad, Islam الanti, that's another business, that's another agenda. But we're talking about جنة here. Look at the next step, the next trip, the third one, quickly. He arrived. Ibrahim عليه السلام. قيل أنه كان يركب البراق. It was said that he used to ride a buraq, a mule between the donkey and the camel that drive quickly. So he arrives. He found Ismail عليه السلام also hunting. السلام عليكم. The new wife now. وعليكم السلام. Where is your husband? The same thing. He's out hunting for us, bringing us provision. قَالَ وَكَيْفَ عَيْشُكُمَا. The same question. How's it going? قَالَتْ بِخَيْرٍ. الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ. Everything is wonderful. This is the attitude. Listen. أَتَشْتَكِي الْخَالِقِ لِلْمَخْلُوقِ. Are you complaining about the Creator to the created? La. Alhamd. Promote Alhamdulillah. Alhamdulillah. Wallah, everything is wonderful. Alhamdulillah. Good health. Alhamdulillah. The family is wonderful. And if you want to add but at the end, add a but. But wallah, عندي بس المشكلة بتاعت البنت والود. ويعني I'm hoping that inshallah, يعني Allah will take care of it. This is the attitude of Ahl al-Iman. But how are you, brother? Oh, terrible. Awful. Things are awful. شوف سيدنا إبراهيم عليه السلام, to be fair, he wanted to further inspect. Maybe she heard about what happened before. قال وما طعامكما. So he asked another question. What kind of food do you eat if things are going well? قالت, she said, اللحم والماء. Water and meat. He said, اللهم بارك لهما في اللحم والماء. Oh Allah, bless their water and bless their meat. وذلك يا إخوة, in Mecca, wherever you go, you see those two. Wherever, حتى if you look at the trash can, you see meat. It's amazing the amount of meat that you see in spite of the number of people that you have in Mecca. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wasallam actually said, if she would have mentioned other things, Ibrahim would have made dua and you would find it in Mecca. When your husband returns, convey my salam to him. وأخبري, and inform them, أن يثبت عتبة داره. This is the type of wife. And the same thing with the husband. Sisters, if you also have an ungrateful husband, do likewise, to be fair. This is the type of husband that you should have. This is the type of spouse that you should have, to make it general. When he returns, he also sensed that there was somebody here. And he asked, she said, yes, an old man. He conveyed salam to you. And he said to keep your doorstep. Yani, he said, this is my father. And he's commanding me to keep you. Now I know the issue triggers a big question in the minds of a lot of the sisters and a lot of the brothers. That means that if your father tells you to divorce your wife, then you're supposed to divorce your wife? Based on that story. And actually there is another story for Bukhari, another incident in Bukhari, that Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu anhu commanded Abdullah to divorce his wife. Abdullah ibn Umar had a wife whom he loved. He used to be in love with her. And Umar said to divorce her. Abdullah ibn Umar went to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, qala ya rasul Allah, O Messenger of Allah, abi ya'muruni an utalliqa zawjati, my father is commanding me to divorce my wife. Qala ya Abdullah, ati' abak, O Abdullah, obey your father. So if you add those two with this one, obvious, they presented this matter to Imam Ahmad rahimahullah. Ya Imam, what is this? If your father is the caliber or close to the caliber of Ibrahim and Umar, absolutely. But your father doesn't pray. He doesn't even know anything about Islam. And he tells you to divorce your wife. No, don't obey him. Umar, رجل محدث بنص الحديث. Umar, Ibrahim عليه السلام is knowing, but Umar is someone who has knowledge, who has deen. For sure he saw something in that woman that would not be fitting his son. That is why you should obey your father if he is like Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu anhu. Brothers and sisters in Islam, the last trip mentioned, by the way, this does not mean that they are only four. They can be more than that. But the last trip was referred to in the Quran and in the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Ibrahim alayhi salam arrived and he saw Ismail sitting by the house and he preparing his archers. You know, he's doing like this to be, because he's going to be going hunting soon. He saw him. He saw his father arriving. He stood up and he giving him a hug. You know, father, son, missing one another thing. And he said to him, Ya Bunay, my son, Inna lillahi baytan hahuna. Allah has a house right here. Brothers and sisters in Islam, you've probably been hearing me. The Kaaba doesn't exist so far. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Inna awwala baytin wudi'a lin-nasi lalladhi bi-Bakkah mubaraka. The Kaaba, or the house of Allah, was raised by the angels. هذا جمهور المفسرين. The angels actually raised the walls of the Kaaba. When Adam alayhi salam descended to earth, him and his wife came and did tawaf around it. And it was ruined. His children raised the foundations again. And during the flood, which happened at the time of Nuh, it was destroyed. You see, Nuh came before Ibrahim alayhi salam. That is why when you read Ibrahim alayhi salam in his way out after he placed Hajar and Ismail, he said, Rabbana inni askantu min durriyati biwadin ghayri di zara'in inda baytika al-muharram. Near your house. So the house existed from the beginning of time. But raising the that is why when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala spoke about it in the Quran, he said, وَإِذْ يَرْفَعُ إِبْرَاهِيمُ الْقَوَاعِدُ مِنَ الْبَيْتِ وَإِسْمَعِيلُ. Ibrahim alayhi salam and Ismail are raising the foundations of the house, not building it, not the foundations were there. And Allah says what? وَإِذْ بَوَّأْنَا لِإِبْرَاهِيمَ مَكَانَ الْبَيْتِ. بَوَّأْنَا يعني أَرَيْنَا. We showed him the location of the house. أَلَّا تَشْرِكْ بِي شَيْئًا وَطَهِّرْ بَيْتِي. Now clean it from the flood and raise the foundation. So the Kaaba exists. Ibrahim said to Ismail, Ya Bunay, my son, Allah commanded me to raise to a house for him here in that place. Are you going to help me? Yes, my father, I'll help you. I'll help you. I'll always, you know, one of the most wonderful things that you have a family that can help you in the path of obedience. Yeah, if there is a blessing, a family that can help you to make it to Jannah. وَذَلِكَ جَاءَ التَّحْذِيرُ يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا إِنَّ مِنْ أَزْوَاجِكُمْ وَأَوْلَادِكُمْ عَدُوًّا لَكُمْ فَاحْذَرُوهُمْ. Some of your spouses and your kids are enemies. Because what? They will distract you away from the path. A blessing. Look at Ibrahim, the blessing. A wife tells him, Allah commanded you, go. A son says, go ahead and execute. Yeah, let's build the house. So Ibrahim alayhi salam raised the foundation of the Kaaba. وشوف, subhanallah, in close to closing here, look at this verse. فيه آيات بينات. In the house, in the Kaaba are clear signs. هذا إيه تعميم عام, general. يأتي التخصيص إيه. Look at the special sign that you should reflect upon. مقام إبراهيم. The station of Ibrahim, which is the golden thing that you see next to the Kaaba. What is so special about that golden thing? A lot of the Muslims, they go out there and touch it and kiss it. La, you're missing the point. What's in there is a rock. On it, the feet of Ibrahim are printed. What is so special about this? What? Look. Allah commanded Ibrahim alayhi salam to raise the foundation of the Kaaba. This command to be completed, I'm standing in the ground and I raise the wall as far as my fingertip reaches. Khalas. Done. I fulfilled. La. Ibrahim. Ihsan. Maqamul Ihsan. That you excel. No, I want to do the best job I can do. He invented that idea. He introduced that idea to humanity, that you can bring a rock, you stand on it, you raise yourself up so that you can raise the walls more. Something that you place, you stand on, and then Ismail goes, brings the rock. Now while he's standing on that rock, because of the heaviness of the bricks, his feet printed. And subhanallah, in spite of that excellence in execution and performance, after he raised the foundation, he goes around the Kaaba making tawaf, and he says what? Rabbana taqabbal minna. He still wants Allah to accept this from me. Please accept this from me. In spite of that excellence, in spite of manzilat al-ihsan, you did? Oh, كانوا قليلا من الليل ما يهجعون أهل الإحسان. The people of الإحسان, they hardly sleep at night. They bring tahajjud all night. وبالأسحار هم يستغفرون. And at the time of Sahar, at the time of Fajr, استغفر الله, استغفر الله, استغفر الله. هذا خوف الرجاء. Alternation. ربنا تقبل منا إنك أنت السميع العليم. شوف. ربنا وجعلنا مسلمين لك. يا الله, make me and my son two Muslims to you. Muslims. Muslims. ومن ذريتنا. From our offspring. أمة مسلمة لك. And we want to learn our deen. We don't want to come up with bid'ah. We don't want to do what our ancestors are doing. وَأَرِنَا مَنَاسِكَنَا. Show us the rituals. وَتُبْ عَلَيْنَا إِنَّكَ أَنْتَ التَّوَّابُ الرَّحِيمُ. شوف, النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول, أنا دعوة إبراهيم ونبوءة موسى ونبوءة عيسى. I am the supplication of Ibrahim and the prophecy of Isa عليه السلام. رَبَّنَا وَابْعَثْ فِيهِمْ رَسُولًا مِّنْهُمْ. From the offspring of the son Ismail, send the messenger to teach them the book and the knowledge and the wisdom. No. And I am the prophecy of Isa عليه السلام. وَمُبَشِّرًا برسول يأتي من بعد اسمه أحمد. When Ibrahim عليه السلام completed the task, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to him, وَأَذِّن فِي النَّاسِ بِالْحَجِّ يَأْتُوكَ رِجَالًا. Now what I want you to do is to call upon mankind to come and perform Hajj to this house. الأثر في تفسير ابن جرير الطبري الحافظ ابن حجر صححه. He said, يا رب, I'm here in the desert. Who's gonna hear me? I'm gonna make a call for Hajj, proclaim, ask, invite people to come perform. Who's gonna hear me? قال عليك الأذان وعلينا البلاغ. All what you have to do is call. And we'll make sure that people hear this. And شوف يا أخوة, when we go to the لبيك اللهم لبيك لبيك لا شريك. A lot of the حجاج, they say that, but they don't pay attention to what they're saying. Oh Allah, I'm responding to you. The call of Ibrahim reached me. Ibrahim made that call along. I'm responding to you. All the people every year they go. لبيك اللهم لبيك لبيك لا شريك لك لبيك. Responding to the call of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In closing, and I really mean it this time. يعني subhanAllah, one of the most fascinating things that even prophets and messengers answered this call. الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم كما في صحيح مسلم حديث ابن عباس, he passed by a valley قال أي واد هذا؟ What is the name of this valley? قالوا الوادي الأزرق. This is the blue valley. وكأني أنظر إلى موسى. As if I'm looking at Musa. Musa came and performed Hajj and he passed by this valley. وكأني أنظر إلى موسى له جؤار بالتلبية. His voice is so loud with the تلبية. لبيك اللهم لبيك. And it's a sunnah to do this. موسى. أي ثنية هذه؟ What is the name of that place? قالوا ثنية هرشا أو هرشا ضبطين. وكأني أنظر إلى يونس بن متى. As if I'm looking at Yunus. Sitting on his camel, wearing a reddish wool piece of cloth, and he is saying the تلبية. وفي مسند أحمد, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم says, لا يهلن عيسى بن مريم بفج الروحاء حاجا أو معتمرا أو ليثنيهما. By Allah, عيسى will pass by a valley called الروحاء. عيسى, when he descends to earth, when he comes back to earth, عيسى بن مريم will pass by this valley in his way to perform Hajj or Umrah or both of them. One of the amazing things too, look at the reward of building a house for Allah in earth. Ibrahim constructed a house for Allah in earth. You know when the Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam went to Al-Isra wal Mi'raj, the journey of Al-Mi'raj, ascension, you know where did he see Ibrahim? Look at the reward. الجزاء من جنس العمل. The reward is normally from the type of act that you do here. Allah has a house, a Kaaba, for the angels out there. He saw Ibrahim, Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, the night of the ascension, he saw Ibrahim sitting down on that Kaaba, placing his back to the walls of that Kaaba. فنسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى أن يجعلنا من الذين يعمرون مساجد الله. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم. الحمد لله رب العالمين له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. Brothers and sisters in Islam, you're approaching the best days of the year, the first 10 days of the month of the Hijjah. Of course, if you cannot make it to Hajj, this is the best thing that you can do, Hajj and Umrah during these days. That is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala prescribed that visit during these days. If you're staying behind, you're never deprived. But just remember that if you want to offer a qurbani, when you see the crescent of the Hijjah, you're supposed to refrain from cutting your nails and cutting any of your hair. حديث أم سلمة في صحيح الإمام مسلم إذا رأيتم هلال ذي الحجة وأراد أحدكم أن يضحي فليمسك عن شعره وأظافره. طيب, the ninth day, the day of Arafah, don't forget to fast this day. الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم كما في صحيح مسلم حديث أبي قتادة, he said it expiates the sins of the previous year and the coming year. So you're not deprived. Make tawbah during these 10 days. Fast as many days of these 10 days except the day of Eid. اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا وإسرافنا في أمرنا وثبت أقدامنا وانصرنا على القوم الكافرين. اللهم أرنا الحق حقا وارزقنا اتباعه وأرنا الباطل باطلا وارزقنا اجتنابه. اللهم إنا نعوذ بك من الفتن ما ظهر.
فاسألوا أهل الذكر إن كنتم لا تعلمون.